This week, Housemaid's thoughts turned to the final.
Everyone who's here now wants to be at the final.
I'd love to win a show like this.
There is a part of me which, you know, is a survivor and doesn't want to give up.
To be, you know, the last people standing here, it means a lot.
It's just a dream I've always had.
Tonight, facing a double eviction, Carol, Courtney, Louis, Mario and Vicky. Who makes the final? Who leaves tonight? You decide. Please welcome your host, Emma Willis.
On our hands. Yep, as we hurtle towards Friday's final, your votes tonight will decide which six celebrity housemates have made it all the way. And hoping they don't fall short are the five nominated housemates all facing the chop tonight. Carol, Courtney, Louis, Mario and Vicky need your vote. So if you want to see them lording it all the way into the final, then you need to get dialing. Remember, you are voting to save. To save Carol from a landline call, 090-2050-803. Or from a mobile, 650-5803. To save Courtney from a landline call, 090-2050-5805. From a mobile, 650-5805. To save Louis from a landline call, 090-2050-5809. Or from a mobile, 650-5809. To save Mario from a landline call, 090-2050-5810. Or from a mobile, 650-5810. To save Vicky from a landline call, 090-2050-5813. Or from a mobile, 650-5813. Mobile and BT landline votes cost 35p. Other landlines may vary. Voting closes later in the show. Votes cast after the lines close won't count. Please do not try to vote if you're watching Channel 5 Plus One or on demand. And for full terms, go to channel5.com/BBVote. Okay, let's get you right up to date with all the latest action from the house. And lucky Louis receives a belter of a present.
Dear 20, 8:37 p.m. Abs has a gift for Louis.
Don't know if I can. Stitch it up. It's just too beautiful.
Oh, please, it'd be a pleasure, Louis.
Oh, my God.
Please. Yeah, it should fit as well. You've got the whole...
Oh, babe, it was so fit. I'm just getting it. I'm saying I can't, but I'm like, yeah, it's so fit.
Trying it on at the same time.
Listen,
it's beautiful. It looks rough.
No, really.
Please,
I know you've gone to nature and everything.
It's an absolute pleasure. I really have no need for these things anymore, man. And you showed the interest, and I'd love it to be with you, man. Just as a little thank for my letter.
That
and
is so wonderful.
I appreciate it, man.
You're most welcome.
I can't believe that. That is so generous and so me. What? I'm not gonna fight it anymore. I'm just gonna take it.
Rock it.
Courtney and Lauren are talking about what lies ahead.
Whoever stays tomorrow will be in the final.
Yeah. It's only a couple days.
One more day. Well, two more days, really.
Technically.
Vicky's in the garden. Carol is in the diary room talking about Vicky.
I don't think she's been playing a game, but I don't think she's... I mean, she kind of just exposed herself the other night. And that... She really let her guard down. I know she's been drunk in here before, but... And I, you know, I don't think Vicky's a nasty person. I don't think she's horrible. But I know, I think she is tricky. I think that's the thing. She's tricky. And I just feel, I don't know, not hoodwinked, but just a bit. I feel like I don't know her anymore, weirdly, which is odd after nearly three weeks.
...9:40 p.m. Housemates have been enjoying some drinks provided by Big Brother. Vicky is still on Carol's mind.
I think she don't like me anyway now. I don't like her though, so it's fine. I know you've made friends with her, but I don't like her. I really hope she goes tomorrow night. I do.
She will.
I hope so. Because if I fucking go and she doesn't, I'm gonna kill myself.
Oh my God, I can't handle the suicide threat.
Lauren and Vicky are in the garden.
I think Carol's dropped a bottle of wine.
You didn't drop anything, did you?
She would never scream unless it involved her. You know what I mean? If, like, she saw a child slaughtered in the street, she'd go, God, step over it. But the minute it's a bottle of red wine, coinage. She tells you off and you don't want to hear it, just walk away.
Yeah.
Oh, you could always do that. Fuck off, Carol. Fuck off. Because if I was here for the next 2 days, I'd be going, fuck off, Carol. Who's used the air dryer? Who's got that? Where's my wine?
I'm trying to, you know, but I'm getting rolled eyes.
Rolled dial.
No, roll.
No, I heard
yeah,
you.
Yeah, from V. Venomous V. Don't want my last night ruined.
It won't be, of course it won't. It doesn't have to be. There's no.
I don't
there's
want
no,
it, I don't want it, I just don't want it. I don't want
there's
it.
No ruining in anything.
Okay, good.
Housemates night, then you have to vote to save your favourite. Remember, your votes tonight will determine which six celebrity housemates can proudly say, I made it to the final in 2013. So if you want your favourite to be in the running for the crown, you need to vote to save them. From a landline, call 090 20 50 58 and add the number of the housemate you want to save. From a mobile, call 650 58 and add the number of the housemate you want to save. To save Carol, add 03. To save Courtney, add 05. To save Louis, add 09. To save Mario, add 10. To save Vicky, add 13. Mobile ABT landline votes cost 35p. Other landlines may vary. Voting closes later in the show. Please do not try to vote if you're watching Channel 5 Plus One or On Demand. And for full terms, go to channel5.com/BBVote. OK, a word of warning to you very good people. You need to be quick because lines will close in just over 4 minutes' time. OK, after the break, Carol and Vicky, they've got their claws out and we'll have the first eviction of tonight's double bill. Who's coming out? We'll find out in a few minutes. Welcome back to Celebrity Big Brother, the live semi-final. So, the vote lines for tonight's eviction are now closed. Please do not call, as your vote will not be counted. So, that's it. Before I talk to the house and before we get a housemate out, there is just time for another catch-up on yesterday's action, and all those housemates do is whine, whine, whine.
...10:36 p.m. It's bedtime for Courtney and Lauren.
Good night, baby.
Oh. Housemates have been drinking for over 2 hours.
Are you taking the red?
Yeah.
I'm not fucking taking the red. Are you joking?
Might give us more.
I'll put it in a cup, Carol, and then you can't see how much I'm drinking.
No, Vicky, you're not taking the red. You've had two bottles of rosé on your own.
No, she only had one.
No, I don't think I have. But
she had one.
Just have a big swig, Carol, and then I'll give it you back.
I can't stand Vicky.
There you go. God.
I'm hungry.
I want some pizza. I know I would never think that, but I want some pizza. There's rice in the fridge if you want to. There's rice and there's all the stuff we chop. Well, they chop. I say we. I just watched.
My eyes were stinking.
There's going to be a row tonight.
I don't understand why she picks us like that every time she has a drink.
You're right. Absolutely.
I'm right.
She's ready to bite. You're right.
I know.
But you can just totally ignore it and rise above it.
I actually don't like her anymore.
I just don't like seeing her like that. I don't like it.
Well,
like,
that's what she's like.
All of us get drunk and remain the same
just
way.
Me. That's what she's like.
I don't like seeing her, this that's whole different
she's
person.
She's up for it for me tonight. I know.
I'm just saying,
she's spoiling.
Don't take the bait.
I'm not going to do it, Louis.
Really ruin the night if anyone bites. But if
it's not going to happen because this is, you know, could be my last night and me and Mario.
Absolutely, and me.
...11:04 PM. Vicky has been in the diary room offloading about Carol for 26 minutes.
I just want her to say something to me and then I can snap at her because she talks about people behind the backs, you see. If she ever came and said, I didn't like that, what you did, I'd be able to do it then. It's not like I'm biting my lip. I mean, I don't... She's probably... she does make me laugh, and she's a very, very bright woman. And I appreciate that. And I like people who have opinions. But I think she is selfish. She doesn't listen.
She's disgusting. I can't stand her. I can't look at her today. If she gets to stay tomorrow and I don't,
she won't.
I'm gonna fucking kill her.
She won't.
I'm right. No, I'm not gonna shirt.
Did I have any wine?
No, there's no wine left anywhere.
Oh,
no.
You drank it then?
No, you drank it all.
No, I didn't.
Yes, you did.
No, I left it in safekeeping.
Carol.
Did you drink it, Carol?
No.
Who drank it then?
Well, it wasn't me, babe.
I think we all did, Vic. I've had some.
No one drank any rosé.
Vicky,
nobody drank any rosé apart from you. So if there's any rosé, that's you.
No, it was red. Carol, it was red that I had before I went up.
Oh, well, we didn't drink it.
Night, gang.
Good night.
Did I leave any bubble around here?
No.
Spoiling for a fucking fight. She's revolting.
Nasty, selfish, opinionated. You can play it all back to her. Doesn't have any wine, goes to bed, doesn't want to mix with anyone. Sort yourself out. Feel sorry for you. Let's get my little posse around me, let's get my whispering corner. Well, good luck to your love, because you're going to need them.
...22 minutes later. Carol is asleep, and Vicky is last to go to bed.
They're going to do twist now. Well, we can evict the third person, but they get to stay on the first one. I want it all up. Think about that, Edward. Vicky is the most annoying person in here, right? But if we get to vote out, we vote out.
Well, we all know what result Carol's been dreaming of, but the question is she right? You have been voting for the last 2 days, and the results are in. It's time to talk to the House for the first time tonight. Celebrity Big Brother House, this is Emma. Carol. Courtney. Louis. Mario. Have spoken, your fate is sealed. For the last 2 days, the British public have been voting to save. I can now reveal the housemate with the fewest votes and sixth to be evicted is...
Seconds
to say your goodbyes.
Oh, I'm so happy. Give Doug a big, big, big crocodile.
Careful down the stairs.
Come
here. Oh my God. Let me look at your lipstick. You're right. Careful down the stairs.
I feel like I'm drinking.
Come on.
You're going to get
Courtney, you have been evicted. Please leave the Big Brother house.
Courtney. I'll see you guys later.
Careful down the stairs.
Okay.
Yeah?
Is my lipstick?
Yeah,
no, it's all right.
Courtney! You have been evicted. Please leave the Big Brother house immediately.
I'll see you later. I'll make you a sign.
Careful down the stairs.
Be careful.
Bye. Careful down the stairs.
Bye.
Careful down the stairs.
Bye.
Careful down the stairs.
Join me.
We're going to meet Doug.
They're going to go warm.
Final and eviction number six. We are joined by our newest evictee, Courtney. I love that every time you're like that.
Yay!
I'm out. I, you're so happy to be out, aren't you? We've heard you moan, really, for quite a while about not wanting to be in that house. So yeah. Now you're out.
Yeah.
Are you at all gutted that you're not there for... It's only really 48 more hours to the
final. I know, yeah. No, you know, to tell you the truth, I'm so proud of myself just for making it this far. You know, I came all from, you know, away from America, and, you know, I didn't think that I was going to make it this far, so I'm thrilled, and I'm proud of myself.
When you knew who was up for nomination tonight, did you guess it would be you going? Are there other people that you thought may have come up before you?
I did, yeah. I just thought that... it's so hard to predict what's going to happen, you know?
Yeah.
I had no idea that Danielle was going to go out. I didn't think Ron was going to leave. I definitely didn't think Dustin or Bruce was going to leave. So I didn't know, but I was hoping I was going to leave. It wasn't that bad. But I didn't know. But I'm obviously thrilled and overjoyed and so proud of myself.
What's it like being out of the house? You seem quite overwhelmed by everything.
It's like a surreal dream because I've been locked up and cooped up in this house for 3 weeks without seeing anybody else, the same people, every day, day in and day out. You know, so it's just so surreal, and it's refreshing to see other people in different people, especially my sweet husband. I love you.
So, Doug is in the audience, yeah. And he has a very large bunch of balloons with him.
Why are they pink?
If anybody's wondering what that is, Doug is sat beneath them, and they are for Courtney. I as you said, this is your first time overseas.
Yeah.
What a holiday destination to pick. Have you learned? Do you think you've learned anything about us Brits by being in that house?
You know, Paris. I would love to, you know, see Paris and go to Paris.
Why did you pick the Big Brother house? This is your first holiday out of America.
Yeah.
It's a very odd holiday destination.
It is, I know. But, you know, I thought that it would be a great experience. And I've really grown into, you know, I feel like I've just grown into a woman now. You know, like when I came in the house, I was only 18. And I just have, you know, learned so much. I've gained so much. I didn't realize that I was that strong to be in that house for 3 weeks. So I just feel more like a woman, and I'm so glad that this was my first time out of the country. It was a great experience. I will never forget it, and I'm truly grateful.
I would imagine one of the great things for you in the house was Lauren, because you had a fantastic friendship with her.
She's a sweetie.
Why do you think the two of you click so much?
Because I love people who are out there who are accepting and different, and she's not afraid, obviously. I mean, look at her, to be herself. She's such a sweetheart, and I truly see her for who she is.
Quite a few of the housemates commented after about the first week that maybe she smothered you a little bit, mm-hmm. You know, because it was just the two of you. And just after that, we did kind of see you break away for a couple of days and go and mingle with the rest of the house, because up until that point, you had really only been with Lauren.
Right.
Did you ever feel that? Did you ever feel that you were kind of maybe being stifled by her a little bit?
I don't feel smothered. I just think that, you know, she, you know, obviously felt a connection with me, and I had no problem with it. But, you know, then again, it is nice to, you know, intermingle with other people, and I, you know, was craving that. But by all means, I adore Lauren, and there was no way I felt smothered anyway.
Okay.
I miss her already.
Are you going to keep in contact with her?
Of course.
We did see you say that you would exchange details with her.
Yeah. I want to invite her over to our house, if that's okay with you. I already invited her.
So from one person you got on really well with to somebody that you didn't really see eye to eye with, and that was Mario in the beginning. The two of you never really hit it off, and then all of a sudden Big Brother were like, let's put together the people that are having difficulties, and you were tied together for a whole day.
Yeah.
So do you feel like you kind of broke down some of those barriers of why you didn't get on, and do you feel like you got to know him a little bit better?
Not really. It was kind of a weird way to bond.
We saw you bonding here touching fingers.
We were bored, I guess. I don't know. It was boring, and he grabbed my hand first, I must admit. But there was nothing there, honestly. I'm not attracted to him. Mm-hmm. Even if I was single, he's a handsome man, but it's just, I'm not attracted to him.
Not your type.
No.
When we saw Big Brother's Bitch Fest, there was talk about you guys flirting together.
Yeah.
So how did that make you feel? Did you start to worry? Because obviously you have a husband, there's people watching on the outside, and your head must have been all over the place.
I don't even remember it. Seriously, there's wine, and I'm a lightweight, and I honestly feel bad. I can't wait to watch the clip. I don't know how I'm gonna feel. I don't know if I should watch it with you. I don't know. I don't remember it. I honestly do not remember it. And it was innocent, you know. It wasn't. I wouldn't be doing that if I had feelings for him or was attracted to him in any way. I just wouldn't
We did see you, as you said, drinking wine, being a bit of a lightweight, having a good time and really letting your hair down. Did you have fun in there?
I did. Because
you did talk a lot about wanting to leave.
I had a blast. I mean, when that wine came out, it was like the only escape. Do you know what I mean? Like, Carol and I were fighting over the bottle at one point. Like, you know, there's no escape. You can't even go in the bathroom without people banging on the door. You know, you can't have a time to yourself. So when you have alcohol, it just kind of, you know...
We're running out of time, I'm so sorry, but did you learn, did you enjoy being independent? Because we saw you say that you depend on Doug quite a lot when you're outside, and you had to look after yourself in there.
Yeah, so did
you enjoy doing that?
I did, and I gained strength, and, you know, that's one of the reasons why I feel more like a woman, because, you know, I was independent, and I feel great, so I'm very grateful.
Will you ever put a stock cube in a kettle again?
I don't know, maybe.
Please, never die never! sum up your experience for us.
My experience has been beautiful, stressful, crazy, all over the map. But at the end of the day, I'm so glad I did it. And I'm truly grateful and blessed.
Courtney, thank you so much for your wonderful body. Here are your best bits. It's Courtney Stodden. I've never seen anyone like her in my life. I could just watch her all day. She's like a real-life Cindy doll.
Just like a human stick woman.
Are them slippers?
Yeah!
She's like porn.
I mean, my ears were killing me last night.
Regardless of gender and age, I think that love is love.
She married a 50-year-old dude when she was 16.
That's it?
Okay. All you are is a set of tits and blonde hair.
It's hard because I'm only 19.
She's 19, not 9.
She's just letting it loose here.
It makes you feel really uncomfortable.
Shut up!
You're 19, you've got to grow up.
You witch tit.
It's quite nice to be around her. She makes me feel fluffy.
You know, you have to be like that.
Courtney's lovely. I'm fascinated by her.
I'm horny, smart, and positive.
I'm truly blessed to, you know, be able to experience such a beautiful adventure with all these people.
Thank you so much. Go and see Doug. Okay, should we get another one out? Yes. For the second time this evening, the votes are in. You have made your decision. It's time to talk to the house. Celebrity Big Brother house, this is Emma. The viewers have spoken. Your fate is sealed. For the last 2 days, the British public have been voting to save. I can now reveal the housemate with the fewest votes and seventh to be evicted is...
I can't tell you.
Louis, you have lost your place in the Celebrity Big Brother house. You have 30 seconds to say your goodbyes.
Oh, well, darling.
Oh, 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 my God, you slaves.
Oh, I cannot tell you. Oh, Vicky, any messages? Messages, darling?
Yes.
Mitch and Lovin. Right,
Louis,
I've got it.
You have been evicted.
Louis!
Please leave the big brother house.
I will.
Tell him!
Eviction. We are joined by our newest evictee, Louis! firstly,
yes.
Your reaction tonight,
yes.
the reaction you received from the audience,
yep.
and on Friday as well,
yep.
was phenomenal.
Fantastic.
And you look so shocked by that.
I was, because I don't know what the public see, but I may have looked unappreciative of my Big Brother journey. Because,
sometimes.
Because I really struggled. I really did struggle. I found it really difficult being with those people and just some, you know, I mean, just some baggage I took in the house with me. And,
mm-hmm.
you know, I thought it would be really easy, but it's not. It is a real mental task. It's not a physical one
yeah.
as such. It is a real mental task and a challenge to... just keep yourself in control, really.
So how does it feel to be out now, then?
It is fantastic. I'm so happy to be... I'm so happy I've done it, but I'm so happy I'm out. There are people in there who so want to win, and it means so much to them, and my journey wasn't that in there. I had a lot of time to think about a lot of things, but it wasn't about the winning so much. But
yeah.
It has been an amazing experience.
You were nominated this week. You were nominated in pairs this week, and you were nominated.
Every week, darling.
You were nominated by Carol and Lauren.
Yes.
Does that surprise you at all? Because
no.
you and we'll get onto your relationship
yep.
with Carol in a little while. But a majority of the time, you kind of seem to get on quite well. So when she nominated you, I was quite surprised.
Yeah. No, not at all. I think because we did have a close. There was a group of us that had a close relationship,
yeah.
and I think you know, like I say, I don't know what was shown, but I know Carol was there for times in the house when I was really struggling, and I think her judgment would have been partly on the struggle I was having, and all partly because I wasn't pleasant to be around sometimes, because I was so in a hole and not having a good time. I was extremes. I was up
yeah.
here or I was down there,
yeah.
and it's difficult because everyone is
Which
on a
is
journey.
Which is how Lauren found you, actually.
Yes.
She said she was either really high or really
yeah.
low. There was never any kind
yeah.
of, you know, medium ground with
yeah.
you. Now, you said all the way through this, from the minute you walked in, that it's a game.
Yep.
You're there to play the game.
Absolutely.
This is a job for you.
Yep.
Let's have a look at you.
Yep. You know, this is show business. We all say we're going to exchange numbers and see each other. If we pass at an event or something, yes, but they're not going to become my best friends
no.
because I've already got my life full.
He's getting paid. It's a game. He has no emotional ties to anybody in here. He doesn't care.
He doesn't feel any guilt or remorse for saying anything about people or putting people up for nomination, and I find that quite cutthroat.
I'm not having a problem with nominating these people. It's what we're in it for. It's what we've got to do, and so what? What you have to remember, Lauren...
Yeah.
It's a game. This is a game.
This is a game.
Louis really doesn't give a flying fudge cake.
You're offended that I nominated you, and I don't care. Yeah.
But did we see your game face slip a couple of days ago when you were in the diary room and you said, I didn't really care, but now I'm at this point, I'd actually quite like to be here on Friday,
yeah.
and if I win, then it's great. Because
yeah.
hearing that reaction and knowing people are saving you,
yeah.
feels really nice.
Yeah.
So I mean, would you like to have stayed?
I would like to have stayed because it is a job, but you do lose sight of that when you're in there because it's bigger than a job. You absolutely do lose sight of that. But also, you do have to think about people who are taking the time to vote for you, and it is, you know, it's not nice for them to think, you know, I'm picking up the phone to vote for you and you don't want to
do
this.
Because you know what, there are a lot of people in there saying, I want to go. Yeah. Courtney always wanted to go.
At one point, everybody said it. Yeah. I mean, I was like from like about day three thinking, oh God, you know, I want to go. God, I've had enough. I can't cope with this. But everyone at some point did say, like I say, you know, I was extreme up and down, but everybody is on their own journey there. And that's why it was difficult to be around someone like me when I was down, because everybody, regardless of what their struggles are, is struggling in that house. And I can, when I was in the dining room, I'd always say, you know, I feel so dramatic saying, oh, it's such a struggle because people watch us sunbathing and look as though we're doing nothing. It's a mental task.
Yeah.
That's what it is. And it really is endurance. And, you know, good luck to anyone in there who's going to get into the final and win.
Now, you said that Carol helped you out in your really hard times in there. You had a really interesting, for me watching, a really interesting relationship. Tell us what your relationship was. Because, as I said earlier, it started amazingly, and then recently we've seen you really kind of, not to each other's faces, but be really peed off with each other.
Well,
so what is it about the two of you?
I think that we are both strong characters, and I think that as you get towards the end in here, what I said about the beginning, it's a game and I don't really care about you or how you feel.
Yeah.
You do start to care what you say and how you feel, because you do feel remorse sometimes for what you've said because you're struggling as well, and you think you can't make judgment on everybody about how you feel, and that's something I learned. Because I was like, oh, I don't care. I would think that I could say something to someone and they wouldn't care.
This is me and my journey, whereas you have to adapt and think of everybody
else. And as you get in there for the longer time, you actually understand that everybody is struggling, everybody has that journey, and sometimes it's just not right to say those things, no matter how you feel. And that's something I learned, and that's how I became with Carol at the end, because, you know, she is tough of old... Oh, shit, I can't speak. As tough as old boots.
But you are both very much like that. You're very direct. You will say what you think.
Exactly.
Do you think if it had have reached boiling point, it would have exploded? Did you kind of have that unwritten mutual thing for each other where you went, do you know what, it can never go there because it would just kick off?
Yeah, I think we knew not to, because I think we knew that neither of us would back down. And there was moments like when Carol had one glass of wine too many that Carol was always right and she is always right. And that was just Carol, and you had to let that go, because if you had taken the bite, it would have just been such an unhappy house, and it was quite harmonious, believe it or not.
OK, we've only got 30 seconds left, but we love your responses to people, so just some very quick-fire questions. Who's the worst person to live with in there?
I would say, Courtney.
Who's the biggest fake?
It's really difficult, and I've championed Lauren all the way, but there's been an immense change in her, which has astounded us all. So I don't know if it's a fake or it's because of certain reasons that she has changed.
OK, and you said that there are some people that are desperate to win.
Yes.
Who are they?
It's Courtney and Charlotte, I'd say, are desperate to win. And there's a big competition between them two.
Who would you like to see win?
I think because of my relationship with Charlotte, I'd prefer Charlotte, because I tried very hard with Lauren, and I always championed her, but she just didn't see any good in me in that sense. So I would champion Charlotte. No matter what she does, she's got a heart and she is a good girl.
It may have been tough, Louis, but you have been absolutely fantastic.
Oh,
thank you so much. Here are your best.
Thank you.
It's Louis Spence.
I'm not too keen on those sofas. I'm not happy with the colours either, really.
You're just a big show-off.
You've got it, darling. I see a red light and I'm off.
Louis says really funny stuff about everyone and I can't help but laugh.
That's it, Mario. Really stretch that out, Mario. She worked it with that bleach blonde hair and, you know, a minge out.
I know I've got a big vagina.
Oh, so you're a big willy.
I don't know if I'm just a mercenary bitch, but the fact is, I'm not having a problem with nominating these people.
Are you feeling like shit, Vicky, or not?
Yeah.
Yeah, you made a bit of a twat yourself.
How many times can you pirouette and do a bit of a thing? Is that a career?
If she's pissed off the fact I've put her up, I just don't give a shit.
Just see her. I mean, just see her.
Listen, tummy.
Get over it, you fucking Botox-faced, trout-faced witch.
I'm all right. I am all right.
And it's
day, Louis was set a secret mission by Big Brother.
Oh my god!
Oh yeah!
Titty!
I love Louis, I think he's awesome.
Louis came and you just farted.
I can feel it!
I just put this piece of paper back. Did you want it back there?
Actually, maybe a bit lower down. That's exactly the spot.
I just let that fall. Oh, sorry. Did I just lose a testicle?
Will now decide who will be crowned king or queen of Celebrity Big Brother. For Abs to win from a landline, call 090 20 50 58 01, or from a mobile 650 5801. For Carol to win from a landline, call 090 20 50 58 03, or from a mobile 650 5803. For Charlotte to win from a landline, call 090 20 50 58 04, or from a mobile 650 5804. For Lauren to win from a landline, call 090 20 50 58 08, or from a mobile 650 5808. For Mario to win from a landline, call 090 20 50 58 10, or from a mobile 650 5810. For Vicky to win from a landline, call 090 20 50 58 13, or from a mobile 650 5813. Mobile and BT landline votes cost 35p. Other landlines may vary. Voting closes in Friday's live final. Please do not try to vote if you're watching on demand. And for full terms, go to channel5.com/BBVote. OK, remember, you are voting for who you want to be your champion of Celebrity Big Brother 2013. Up next, it's the gripping Wentworth Prison. And after that, it's Bit on the Side with AJ and Ryland.
Hi, guys. Right, Em. Amazing show. We love a double eviction. Very shocked in the studio. Get down here quick, because we want all the gossip.
Yes, the apprentices Louisa, Emma Kennedy and Luke Morrison are all here to discuss tonight's eviction duo. So, come on down.
I will come on down as quick as my very high heels can carry me. And if you want even more, you can carry on watching Late Night Action at channel5.com/Big Brother. The highlight show will be back tomorrow at 9 p.m. And listen up. Your final Celebrity Big Brother night kicks off on Friday at 8:30 with a countdown show, followed by the live grand final at 9 p.m. Set your alarms, clear your diaries. We'll be back here to crown your champion on Friday. Good night.
It's good to go. Do you know what I mean?
It would be easier, but...
And get everything done.
You've said that you're excited for the Friday.
Oh, I am. I would be, but... No, obviously, because I would be with the little one.
Oh, God.
But if I'm not, I'm perfectly fine about it.
Would it come through now if there was another one? It'd have to be now.
No, they said sit down, so it has to happen.
Maybe they're just doing that, wind us up.
Just wind us up, yeah.
Winding us up.
There isn't going to be another one.